This is the Moysuwe microscope, and we're going to review this. Welcome back to rTech. The packaging, as always, has been very simple these days. So this one comes in a plain cardboard box, eco-friendly packaging, pretty sturdy packaging. And it just says Moysuwe digital microscope. A little bit of text here and there, but nothing much to describe the product. Let's turn this over. Yeah, on the back you can see that it talks about the magnification this offers, about 50x to 1200. That's a claimed one. It's got a 7-inch screen and it's about 1.76 pounds or about maybe 700 grams, so pretty lightweight. So let's have this opened up. Okay, inside you get a nice manual, which is placed right at the top, and it's talking about how to fix this up. It's a pretty comprehensive user manual, so you'll see a lot of things mentioned inside, and it's got some color photos too, which is really nice to see. And the English isn't too bad. This is really good, and it looks like it can really help you set this up. Okay, let's pull out some of the components here. There's a piece of foam covering the 7-inch screen. So that's where you see the real branding on this. It says Moysuwe. I hope I'm saying that right. There's some sort of a chrome gadget over here. Really shiny stuff. And this looks like the remote control unit for this device. It's pretty simple to understand. It's just the navigation buttons and a couple of click buttons, maybe to record a photograph or a video. It's using a micro USB port as well as a 3.5 mm jack. Let's set that aside, we'll come back to that. Let's get a hold of the screen. So it has a screen guard on it. And before I go to that, this controller unit is very flimsy. So if you have small kids around and if they actually pull it really hard, it's going to knock off the wiring. So you have to be really careful with this. Okay, back to the screen. So this looks like, you know, one of those microscopes which you get in the market, which has this adjustable ring. I have another video which I've done a few years back. And this one is very similar, just that it's got an integration of a screen, which makes it much more easier to have an output. And it looks like it's got a tilt option as well. And the build quality is pretty nice. So here, there are some buttons which let you adjust the brightness, I guess, of the LEDs. There's a memory card slot. And there are a few navigation buttons. There's a power button here on the right, and you also have a LED indication there. And you can actually use this unit without the remote control unit which they have provided. Okay, let's come to the stands. So there are some gooseneck lights, LEDs again. It's going to help you look at some of the stuff a little more precisely. Also see a memory card there, which is about 32 GB, I guess, when I was getting the stuff. And here's one of the clamps. It's aluminum, so it's pretty strong. And there's another micro USB cable here, which they've given. So the power for the stands and these goose lights have been separated. So the microscope has its own power supply. You'll have to actually supply a separate line to these goose lights, which I'll show you how it's done in a moment. Actually, the remote control has an additional micro USB port, which goes into this base plate, and that'll power up these two lights. It's got these nice rubberized pads at the bottom. And I'm guessing this clamp just screws in over here. Like I mentioned, you have some control for the lights there and nice rubberized feet. So this unit works with Windows and your Apple systems without any problem, because I think they have mentioned that it works on both macOS and Windows as well. Some specifications given here. So the photos can go up to 12 megapixel, video is about full HD, and there's a multiple language support. Let's get this assembled. So removing the protective screen from this. and it's a semi-gloss display, sort of. So this unit, when I read the manual, it says that it's used for soldering purposes to avoid reflections of some sort. Not too sure, but you can take off the plastic unit from the tip of this microscope and add this unit so that it actually helps you have lesser reflections from when you're soldering. And this is the tilt I was talking about. The screen is tiltable, which makes it easier for you to see. Here are the items you get in the box. So let's keep this aside. I'm going to start assembling this. So this is a height adjustable stand, and you can see that it has these grooves on which this moves. Made of aluminum, so it's pretty sturdy. It's got a locking screw as well. It's pretty simple to assemble this. There is a small threaded screw at the bottom, which lets you adjust the placement. And then all you need to do is just plug in your monitor on top of this stand. It's as simple as that. It's just a holder for this whole device. So there are some screws which actually tighten the hold of the screen on this metal mount. So once you have it in place, you can just tighten this screw, and that's about it. I'm going to add the memory card which I've offered. There's no branding on it. It just says 32 GB. And I don't even know what class this is, but let's have this inserted in the slot. Yep, and you're good to go. This is the remote control unit. So it's got this 3.5mm jack, which I think it uses to control. So let's plug this 3.5mm jack here. Now the micro USB cord which comes along with the remote is supposed to go to the base plate. So do not plug this in here because it will not power up the device. I powered this thing up and you can see the red LED there glowing. And you need to use a 5-volt supply, micro USB, any mobile charger will do. And it's actually indicating that it's charging. It takes about 2 hours to charge the device fully. And there's a power button there, so let's go ahead and click that. There you go. So there's a light built in the microscope itself. And you can see the whole base plate is actually glowing. And this boots up so quickly, so there's no logos or nothing else. And it's so fast to set it up. I'm just going to show you how fast this is, and you know, you can straight away start putting things under it and it will start showing you display. Let's adjust the height, just trying to see how much you can adjust this. There's not a lot of space for you to actually move it up and down, but it's reasonable. And this is the amount of throw it has. I mean, it's, you can loosen the screw at the back to make it run faster up and down. I would say about 20 centimeters is what it can move. The movement is really smooth. And here you go, it's all set up, and this is how it looks. Let me know what you guys think about this device in the comment section below. I'll leave links in the description in case you're interested. We shall also see some images from this in a moment. And in case you like the video, please do hit subscribe and like the video. Just help us make more such videos. Okay, so here are some settings, and thanks to the remote, it makes it really easy to navigate. You can even use the on-screen controls on the device. The remote is making it a tad easier. So basic settings like resolution for images and the video resolution is available here. It's a very simple UI. There's also a burst mode in case you want to use that. You can set up image quality. I'm guessing it's to save space if you don't want to use it, but I'm going to put it to high. You can also adjust sharpness and have exposure compensation. These are all minute adjustments. It's not going to be heaven and earth, but you can do such things. There's also a screen protection option here. Basically, I think there's going to be burn-in in case you keep something on for a long time. So you can have it shut down automatically in case you leave it on for a long time. And then, of course, language settings. There's a frequency light adjustment in case you have flicker. And there's something called as line assist in case you want grid lines. Yeah, and you can format the memory card here, which I'm going to do now. It takes a bit of time for that. and it's done. And you can also set up defaults. There's also a version module. You can actually check the version of this device. And that's about it. Oh yeah, you can actually add date and time on this. So let's see how this thing looks. I mean, we'll put some things under the microscope. I'm just going to use the manual just to see what comes up first. So initially you don't see any images. You can just use the focus screen. There you go. That print is so coarse, but when you actually look at the manual, it looks really smooth. So this is where this microscope really comes in handy. It's not a professional microscope, but you can see stuff which you really can't see with your naked eyes to a certain extent, right? So they claim 1200x. I'm not sure whether it goes to that extent, but I do have some things which I want to put into this microscope and see how well you can actually look at those images. So you'll actually be a judge for this yourself. So that's the registration symbol, and it's got this yellow tad painting next to it, but when you look at it, you can't see that. The screen is pretty decent. I mean, I thought it's going to be a low resolution one, but you know, in terms of watching it for real, it looks much better than what the camera is actually capturing. So let's put this piece of wire here. Yeah, this is nice. And the goose lights are on. And these are really adjustable thanks to that flexibility on the neck. It's amazing. And you can see the unit is fully charged. The LEDs turn into green. I'm gonna power it up again. Yeah, it's really fast. Okay, here are some items I'm gonna put under the microscope. Here's a pencil tip. I'm gonna show you the image as captured by the micro SD card now. There you go. That's how clear it is. Let's put in a pen here and let's see what it captures. And yes, you can actually see the tip of the pen very clearly. Thanks to those lights, and the stability of this thing really helps you capture things much easier than some of the past microscopes I've seen. I just took it up a level higher. I just put a leaf here thinking that, you know, this is all I can see. But then this is what I could see with my phone or my camera. And when I actually took this closer and focused on this item, I could actually see stuff moving on the leaf. And believe it or not, there's a whole ecosystem on this leaf, which I wasn't aware of. I don't know what these red bugs are, but they're really not visible when I see them directly on the leaf. And there are also some yellow stuff there which are moving, some sort of larvae. And you can also see some brown stuff there. I think those are eggs. And they're actually stuck behind the leaf. And there's no way you can see it with your naked eye. Look how clear that bug looks on this. The beauty of this microscope is it lets you record all the stuff in full HD. And it's really useful for someone who's actually working on a small science project. And definitely going to be useful for someone who's actually doing something with a motherboard or some electronic components. So those are some of the other bugs which I saw, and that's the tip of the pen, and that's so much bigger as compared to whatever you're seeing on the leaf. I put some stagnant water in a small cup, and this is what I could see. A lot of rubbish there, and some things moving around. And when I actually change the focus, actually I can look at the base of this whole thing. I put a scissor there just to see how the edges look, and guess what? They're not fine. I put a toothbrush which isn't used, and it's a slightly old toothbrush, and I could actually see a lot of stuff on that which you really can't see when you look at it normally. You think it's actually clean. There's so much of stuff in there which you can see using this microscope. Here are some of the images which I've put in. So that's the bottom of the brush, and you can actually see the kind of stuff there. Those are the bristles. Put a small piece of memory foam there. There's a lot of rubbish which you can see. An old matchbox which I had. and look at that surface, and that chemical there is worn out so badly, and the match itself. Wow, that's really good. Small piece of copper, and of course you can see coins with this, so this is a piece of copper, and you can actually see the indentations and the scratches, everything on it very, very clearly. Just trying to give you examples of things you can put under this. And here's another image. Okay, now getting into electronics, this is one of the old LED bulbs. And you can actually see the chipset so easily. You can actually see the LED module. These are really tiny. And you can actually see the filaments when you pull out the image. So if you're working on PCBs, it's going to be really easy for you to start working on this. The clearance might be a problem, but you can put stuff and clearly see them exactly where you want them to be. I like this. A lot of times you find it difficult to do soldering, but this will help you. That's the soldering board. Let's check. Okay, what about resistors? How clear are they? Pretty good. So this is exactly what I was talking about. So if you're an electronics guy doing a project, micro soldering, stuff like that, this is going to be really helpful. And look at how clear those resistors are. This is a cable which is used to connect your monitor internally in a laptop. LVGS, I guess, I can't remember the name, but you can actually look at all the teeth on this thing. This is really small. Here's a small circuit board, and I just put this under the microscope, and you can actually see how clear it's going to be. Wow, that is amazing. Check out the image quality from the micro SD card. I mean, it's really useful, right? The image quality is really nice. Everything can be read clearly, and working on things like this for repairs makes it much easier using this microscope. This is amazing. So you can look for fingerprints, you can see how your fingerprints look under this as well. And if you're into gems or gemology, people in that industry can also use this. And it kind of helps you see the quality of stones. I don't know how good or bad this is in terms of a zoom in ability, but very useful for those people into this field as well. Here are some fabrics and several other things you can see using this microscope. Let me know what you guys think about this little device. I'll leave links in the description below. As always, please like the video, subscribe, and share it with your friends who would like to gift this or have one for themselves. Thank you so much for watching rTech. I will see you on the next one. Bye.